Back here at home, holiday travelers are still arriving at the Batangas port, which serves as a gateway to provinces south of Metro Manila. Dennis Datu is there and he joins us with the latest. Dennis?
Yes, Denise, canceled trips and delayed trips of some ships this morning are just of the inconveniences experienced by passengers here at Batangas port. OceanJet's Fast Club canceled its trip to Calapan City in Oriental Mindoro earlier this morning after the Philippine Coast Guard issued a gale warning due to strong waves. But a few hours later, they were allowed to sail after the weather improved. But the problem is that there are already many passengers waiting at the passenger terminal who want to board the ship back to Calapan. Meanwhile, passengers of the Starlight Ferry bound to Katikla were upset after their trip was delayed for almost 5 hours. The passengers bound to Katikla only allowed to board at around 11 a.m. Right now, Denise, the situation here in Batangas Port is very crowded with passengers going home to their provinces 2 days before Christmas. Passengers will experience difficulty in purchasing tickets due to long lines at the ticketing booth, while other shipping lines are running out of tickets, especially in the economy sections. Due to excessive number of passengers, Philippine Ports Authority General Manager Attorney Jason Chago recommended to all shipping lines that their vessels should speed up their engines to get to their destinations quickly so that the passengers don't have to pile up at the port. During Santiago's inspection at Batangas Port earlier, he noticed the very long lines of vehicles outside the Batangas Port waiting to board the vessel and the number of passengers crowding the passenger terminal who could not board immediately because their ship had not yet arrived. Meanwhile, personnel of Europe Animal Industry confiscated several hams and other meat products carried by passengers. Transportation of meat products is strictly prohibited, even if they are cooked, raw, and already processed to the Mimaropa region, especially in Mindoro. This is to prevent African swine fever from contaminating the Mimaropa region, which is a safe zone area. So, Denise, we remind passengers not to try to bring ham during their trip here in Batangas Port. Management of the Batangas Port expects that today there will be at 25,000 passengers, so we advise the passengers to have a lot of patience. Denise.
Thanks, Dennis. More buses have been deployed in Davao City amid a worsening transport crisis there. Krislyn Bulosan joins us with that story. Krislyn?
Denise, 13 buses were deployed to different routes starting Thursday, December 22, to aid the ongoing transport crisis in Davao City that worsened since early December. This is under the peak hour augmentation bus system program of the local government unit. The lack of public utility vehicles, the jeepneys and taxis, is seen as the main factor of why most commuters take at least an hour to ride one, especially during peak hours. Southeastern Mindanao Diversified Operators Cooperative, or SEMDOC, stands that one of the reasons of the shortage of POVs is the increase in fuel prices this year. Manning Duran, the president of the said organization, said in an interview that the POV drivers can no longer earn enough after an entire day's work, given also the traffic during this holiday season. Public utility drivers also refuse to renew their registration worth 10,000 pesos, that they will eventually be phased out as the high-priority bus system will be fully implemented in the city soon. The 74 billion peso worth transport modernization project will replace the deteriorating and aging jeepneys with modern buses to address the problem of traffic congestion. Then-Mayor and now Vice President Sara Duterte has started the planning and implementation of the modernized bus program during her term as mayor. And his sibling, Davao City Mayor Sebastian Duterte, vowed to prioritize the said project during his administration. Meanwhile, the temporarily augmented buses will run up to January 2023 until further notice, according to the LGU. And that so far is the latest here in Davao City. Krislyn Bulosan, ABS-CBN News.
Thanks for that, Krislyn.